implement sort. So let us see what are the steps we need to follow to implement the sort. First one is define the workplace for what the workplace is required or the specific operation. So we need to define the workplace. So is it a training hall? Is it a shop floor? It is an inspection area. So what type of specific operation that you are doing in that particular department or area, we need to specify it. Once you specify it, then what we need to do is note down required and not required items in the workplace, or paste a tag to the not required item. What we can do is we can note down all the items. There'll be some name on the item, and after noting down, we can paste a tag to the not required item. Then third is move the not required items to the red tag area far from the workplace. So every company or every department will have a separate area that is called red tag area. The red tag area is nothing but where we can store unwanted items in that particular area. So once we identify the not required items in the particular work area, we can move those unwanted items to the red tag area. And the fourth is displaying not required items in a sheet. So once you move the unwanted items to the red tag area, we need to display with the date saying that these are the items are we have moved from our workplace. So that is not, that is an unwanted item for your workplace, but that is not a scrap. Therefore, we need to inform to the concerned departments or the concerned users unknowingly they kept the item in that particular place. Therefore, within 3 days, they will take their items to their workplace. Else, if no one is taking, we can scrap the item. Next. So first one is, we need to define the workplace for what workplace is required. Specific operation. In this example, there is a milling process. So for milling process, this is a department or a workplace. What is required to do a milling process? Milling cutters, tools, machines. With respect to milling process, item should be there. If your dispatch items are lying here, that is not a place for it. So this is an example. Then note down the required and not required items in the workplace or paste a tag to the not required items. So we'll note down what is required and what is not required item. Then we'll paste the tag. Then what we'll do, we'll move the not required items to the red tag area far from the workplace. So we'll create a red tag area like this, making a border, and we'll paste in a sheet. In a sheet, we'll paste it. What all the items shall be here. Then displaying not required items in a sheet. We need to display by item wise which item is required, the non-required item, and display it. Then people who unknowingly kept that item in a particular place, so they will take it. Then that is how we can implement sort. And the next one is shine. So what is a shine? A place which is clean for working, that is called shine. Why we need to clean dirt and dust from the workplace? So if there are dirt and dust in the workplace, what happens? That destroys the quality of the floor. Then healthy workplace to work. So this is an effect. So if you clean it, what happens? Healthy workplace will have for us to work. Then a safe workplace to work. The workplace will be very, very safe for us. Then steps to implement shine. So first one is select the workplace to be cleaned. Then list down the items required for cleaning. Maintain a 6S cleaning kit. Then rule for cleaning like shift wise, etc. We need to define. Let us see. So the first one is select the workplace to be cleaned. So we are selected. Is it a shop floor or a working place? We are selected. Then list down the items required for cleaning. What do you want? What do you want to clean? You need a brush. You need a cotton cloth. You need choline or soap oil or floor mat, mask, gloves. What are all things you need to perform that particular cleaning activity? Then maintain a 6S cleaning kit. So we shall have a cleaning kit with all the available resources to perform daily cleaning activity. So then, rules for cleaning like shift wise, etc. Create a system for cleaning activity. So who have to keep it? Separate person, particular timings we need to do cleaning activity. A system to ensure the activity is happening. Like we can make a check sheet, daily check sheet date wise, so that particular person has to sign it. Therefore, what happens? The things are ensured, the cleaning activity is ensured. Then set in order a place for everything, and everything is in its place. We can use ascending and descending order, ABCD series, and 1 2 3 4 5 series for set in order. So let us see what is set in order. Things arranged in a way to get any material within 30 seconds. So there's a 30 second rule. So if you go and ask any item within 30 seconds, they're able to pick that particular item or a document, or a whole document. So that means they have a system to recover something. Suppose if you ask anything for a document or a data, if he's searching, what happens? So the system is not so well in order to pick up something. Therefore, when they want to run a machine or do some process, definitely they'll be keep searching for whatever items required for, to do the particular activity. Then why we need to set in order in the workplace? Let us see. We can identify the item within seconds. Everything available readily when you arrange it and identify it. Then free from uneven motion for searching. So the first thing is you can identify it. Yes, it is. See, for example, we are booking a train ticket. Say if there are no number system, seat numbers. So how difficult is to find out the seats for us? So these are all the common things that is we are using as a part of the 6S. Everything available readily. So whatever the items that is required to run the process, it is available. Then we'll be free from uneven motion for searching. So when you arrange it and you say that this particular item should be only in this area, then you know that every time it will be there only. Therefore, you'll not search for the, and you'll not waste time in searching that particular item. Now, steps to implement set in order. Let us see what are the steps we can use it to implement set in order. So first one is select the workplace and items. Then list down the names of the items and things. Arrange ABCD series for 1 2 3 4 series or 1 2 3 4 series to arrange it. Fix a place for each item. This is very, very important. Fix a place for each item so that every time everyone can identify the item location. So when you fix it, it's very important. So the first one is select the workplace and items for arranging. So you select the item. So these are the items required for this particular work location. Then list down the names of the items and things. Is it a book, files, pen, stand, etc.? Then you list down the items. After listing down, you arrange in ABCD series or 1 2 3 4 series so that you can pick up that particular item anytime by anyone. Then fix a place for each item so that every time everyone can identify the item location. So we need to fix the item by using labels or markings so that everyone knows These items shall be here only. Then implementation of standardize and sustain from 6S. Standardize. Working method shall be same for all the people in the shop floor. This is called standardize. And we can make check sheets or we can make mistake proof. Then sustain. A method to practice the 3S regularly in the shop floor. That is, this also we can use check sheet. So sort, set in order, shine. These things are being followed every day. So that is very important. No, this 3S is very, very important. So that is, we can use checklist for sustaining the activity. Then implementation of safety. So the safety, as we discussed, the safety of the operator is very important. Then safety of the environment, then safety to the floor, safety to the machines. Safety of the operator. What are the safety for the operators? Gloves, safety shoes, safety goggles, safety aprons, safety helmets. So what are the safety for the environment? What are the safety for the environment? Carbon dioxide emission control. So there may be some special process where CO2 is emitting. So what system or method you have in your company to do it very safely without harming the environment? Then how we are going to disposition of waste cotton, the used cottons in our company, how we are going to dispose it? Do you have a method for it? That's very, very important. Then disposition of used coolant oil. So after coolant oil, once it becomes a more solute, that you are going to scrap it. How you are going to dispose it without affecting the environment is very important. Then workplace having temperature 25 to 28 degree F. So the workplace that we run shall have a particular temperature for safety. It comes under safety for the machine as well. Then workplace free to breathe good air. The workplace should be free to breathe good air. This is very, very important. Workplace has exhaust fan in the machining area. So wherever machining area is there, or wherever there is a outcome of gases, we need to have an exhaust fan compulsory. Then safety to the floor. Floor free from oil or dirt. So the floor should be free from oil or dirt. The floor free epoxy. We need to have epoxy so that prevents, it makes very, very nice floor. Floor having minimum friction to walk. The floor shall not have very smooth, where when people are walking they'll fall off, or when you're trying to do some operation you'll fall off. So the floor should have a minimum friction to walk. So this is also one of the safety to the floor. Safety to the machines. Machine stoppage when there is a breakdown. So when there is a breakdown, the machine should stop. So that should be a default program for the supplier. Then tough, high, dense poly doors to the machines. So there is a pressing machines or something, we need to have a poly doors, tough poly doors, where when there is sudden breakdown, something item will come and hit you. So, but those doors will prevent from that. Machine startup after closing the door. So only if the door closes, the machine should start. Because say example, there is a turning process, and keeping the door open when you on it, the machine starts. Then there is a chance that there can be injury to the operator. So this is a very, very, very important, that the safety to the machines is only if the door closes, the machine shall start. So this is very, very important. There should be two program. See, you are given a limit switch to the machine. Suppose if the limit switch did not work, the machine, the door should, the machine should not run. So there should be two criteria. So the next one is, so these are the things we need to consider and we shall implement success in the shop floor. So next, 8 waste in the shop floor. Let us see what are 8 ways, in what way we can reduce it, minimize it.